Welcome to the Road Stop on NewsX. We are in Pilibhit to cover the election campaign of UP Cabinet Minister and a BJP candidate from Pilibhit, Jitin Prasad. Pilibhit is one of Uttar Pradesh's 80 Lok Sabha constituencies which will be going to vote on the 19th of April in the first phase. Pilibhit, the land of flutes and tigers, is the northeasternmost district of Uttar Pradesh, sharing its border with neighbouring Nepal. In 2011, Pilibhit recorded a population of 20,37,225 people, of which 17% are urban and the majority, 83%, are rural. 71% of Pilibhit's population is Hindu, 24% is Muslim and 4% are Sikhs. The 2019 elections saw voter turnout of 67.41% with over 11 lakh voters exercising their democratic right. BJP's biggest star campaigner, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, has held a campaign in Pilibhit for the first time. Meanwhile, SP Chief Akhilesh Yadav also began his campaign across Uttar Pradesh from Pilibhit. The battle for Pilibhit is on. I'm currently standing in the Pilibhit Tiger Reserve area. Once known for the production of flutes, Pilibhit is now famous for its flourishing tiger population. Despite huge human density in the villages that surround this area, Pilibhit has managed to double its tiger population in the last decade to nearly 65 tigers now. However, it's not the tigers of Pilibhit that are making the headlines in this political season. Starting in 1989, Menaka Gandhi was elected to Parliament from Pilibhit six times, twice on a Janata Party ticket, twice as an independent and twice by the BJP. In 2009 and 19, Menaka's son Varun Gandhi contested on a BJP ticket from his mother's bastion and won with a thumping majority. This time, the party has fielded former Union Minister Jitin Prasad from here. The BJP is facing a three-way contest in Pilibhit. Jitin Prasad is up against Anees Ahmed Khan of the BSP and five-time MLA from Nawabganj, Bhagwat Saran Gangwar of the SP. Prasad begins his day with a puja as he proceeds to meet the voters and seek their vote. Hundreds of people across Pilibhit district have gathered to present mementos and introduce themselves to the man who could be their next member of parliament. Political campaigning in Uttar Pradesh is another ball game altogether. We finally caught a moment with Mr. Jitin Prasad. Thank you so much for being with us on NewsX. I want to begin by asking you, sir, why do you think the party chose you to fight from Pilibhit?
No, the party on various issues and concerns decides from the various feedback and mechanism the party has. And in its wisdom, the party has decided to field me, and it's a privilege for me to be that this party has given me this responsibility of fighting the Pilibhit Lok Sabha.
At the same time, you've been campaigning, sir, and I'm sure you've now understood what are the problem areas in the constituency. What really will be the priority areas that you set for yourself?
Priority areas, of course, whatever the work that has been done for the past 10 years under the Modi government and 7 years of the Yogi government, we want to take it to the next level and take it forward. And there's a lot of potential in this district, and that's what we're looking at. From industrialization to agriculture to tourism to, of course, water and other issues that concern the people. And that will be taken to the next level.
Okay. At the same time, do you think Rahul Gandhi's promise to hold a caste census and then a wealth census in India will actually resonate with the voter?
Of course not, because people have seen through all that. It's only an election gimmick. And you have to walk the talk, not just only speak about it on platforms during elections.
At the same time, sir, do you feel that Uttar Pradesh has moved beyond the politics of caste and religion to the politics of vikas?
You are absolutely right. The Modi factor has transcended beyond boundaries of caste and religion, and people are willing to cross that line, which was traditionally the way people had voted. And now, as you've seen, that how the work has been done and India is transforming under the leadership of the Prime Minister, that people are willing to vote for development and for India.
What about the Ram Mandir construction then? Do you think that's going to have a big impact on the minds of the voter?
No, that's the party does development work as well as respects the sentiment of the people. And as far as the temple goes, it is a thing that has been taken by the party, respecting the sentiment of the crores of people, India and worldwide, that are attached to the Ram Mandir movement. And that's what the party's ideology is.
Akhilesh Yadav also began his poll campaign from Uttar Pradesh, from Pilibhit. How do you view your opponents in both the Samajwadi Party and the BSP?
Nothing, because of course people do see through all their work, that they only come out of their drawing rooms when the election process begins, and there is no connect with the people otherwise. And people have seen through that, that the opposition is just not there when people need them.
At the same time, there's no clarity on whether Rahul Gandhi or Priyanka Gandhi will be contesting from Amethi or Raibareli. Do you think the absence of the Gandhis actually puts the BJP in a better position to clinch Raibareli?
I don't think so. There's any factor.
Nothing at all as far as...
I have no clue about them.
At the same time, Sir Robert Vadra is also saying that people want him to contest. The party see him as a political threat?
I really don't know. I have nothing to offer on that.
And the opposition alliance says that arrests of certain chief ministers is indicating that the BJP is scared. Do you feel that the opposition could be successful in creating some sort of a narrative against the BJP?
It's been said once and for all that the law will take its own course and nobody interferes with that.
What's the X factor in the BJP, sir, that is missing in other parties?
I told you that the leadership, that it's India first. It's not about politics, it's about the country and it's about the people. And it's not about elections. It's connecting with them throughout, whenever there's election or no election. That reach has been maintained and the connect is there. And it's not only that the people on the ground, the workers are toiling, the leadership at the top is continuously on the ground and connecting with people. And it's leading by example.
What do you think are the core issues of this election then?
The core issue is the Prime Minister's track record of 10 years of his governance and how he has transformed India.
It is also the occasion of Ambedkar Jayanti. Those who have come to meet Jitin Prasad have also presented him with photos of the father of the Indian Constitution. Jitin ji, several portraits of Baba Sahib Ambedkar given to you today, sir. What do you feel about that?
Well, today is Ambedkar Jayanti, and of course his contribution to the nation can never be forgotten. I pay my tributes to him on his...
And what learnings of his do you take forward as you look forward to your political career in Pilibhit?
To the constitution, this cannot be, this thing is the biggest contribution he's done.
Jitin Prasad was born in Uttar Pradesh's Shahjahanpur on 29th November 1973. He is the son of former Congress Vice President Jitendra Prasad and Kanta Prasad. Prasad did his schooling from Doon School in Dehradun. He studied commerce at SRCC Delhi University and went on to get his MBA from IMI New Delhi. In 2001, Prasad became General Secretary of the Indian Youth Congress. In 2004, he entered Parliament from his hometown of Shahjahanpur. Prasad was a Union Cabinet Minister under the Manmohan Singh government. In 2010, Jitin Prasad tied the knot with Neha Seth and the couple have two kids. After a long tenure in the Congress, he quit the Grand Old Party in 2021 and joined the BJP. He has since been inducted into the Uttar Pradesh Cabinet under Yogi Adityanath. Jitin Prasad is facing a three-way contest against the SP and BSP in Pilibhit. The who's who of the BJP are campaigning to make sure that the voter presses the lotus come 19th of April. Our next pit stop is the Ramlila Maidan in Bahedi. With an eye on clinching an even greater victory for the Bharatiya Janata Party in the 2024 Lok Sabha elections, BJP's star campaigner and Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi Adityanath, has come for the first time ever to the Bahedi district of the Pilibhit Lok Sabha constituency. In his trademark style, he's brought with him two bulldozers as he makes his appeal now to the people of this particular constituency on what the BJP has to offer and also seeks support for the BJP's fresh face, Jitin Prasad.
Ram.
As the crowd rallies to cheers, the BJP puts out its report card before the public.
स्थानीय समस्याएं यह है कि यहाँ कुछ लोग जो सभी यहाँ थोड़े ताकतवर हो गए हैं, उन्होंने यहाँ जमीन कब्जा करने का काम किया है। यहाँ तक कि मैंने सुना है कि रामलीला मैदान की भी जमीन कब्जा करने का प्रयास किया है। उनको मैं चेतावनी देना चाहता हूँ कि मुख्यमंत्री जी का बुलडोजर चलेगा और कोई बख्शा नहीं जाएगा।
समाजवादी पार्टी की सरकार के समय चलता था तो मुख्यमंत्री हो या मुख्य न्यायाधीश, इन सब के काफले रुक जाते थे और माफिया का काफला निकलता था। जब हमने कार्रवाई की उस माफिया के खिलाफ और उसको रगड़ करके कोर्ट के सामने प्रस्तुत किया तो उसकी पैठ गीली हो गई थी।
Was Yogi Adityanath's vociferous support for the BJP candidate of Pilibhit a confidence booster? Let's find out.
And you can ask the people and the response here. You can see there is the Modi wave.
After a successful public rally in Baheri, Jitin Prasad is making his way back to Pilibhit city where further public meetings are lined up for him. While Uttar Pradesh is not uncharted territory for Jitin Prasad, this is the first time that he's contesting from the Lok Sabha constituency of Pilibhit. Contesting from a family bastion will require an extra effort from him to make himself a familiar face and name before the elections. From a full day of campaigning, the BJP candidate has made his way to Amaria village for a public meeting with the Sikh community, where leaders of the community have been given the platform to express their views and demands. I just want to understand from you, how are you hoping to transform Pilibhit?
It has already been under process in the 10 years of the Modi government and the 7 years of the Yogi government. The double engine that's working, you can see there's a cross section of highways that's crossing across Pilibhit, and other development projects which I myself have sanctioned as PWD minister, the bridge for 200 crores, the 100 crore road for industrial park, and we want to take it to the next level. The Prime Minister himself came for the first time in 10 years and addressed a rally which shows the focus of the Modi government in the future, that Pilibhit will be one of the priority areas. And there's a lot of scope for tourism as well as other issues that are here for regards to the farmers. And there's a sugarcane belt. We'll ensure proper payments, which is already improved dramatically. And procurement of paddy and wheat. Of course, there's one more issue, which is the man-animal conflict, which people are, this thing will ensure there's a, it's already under process. There is a some sort of a screen that's being put up where across the border areas of the jungle, which will ensure that.
So at the same time, there are already excellent roads and highways that are built. But what's the next step as far as infrastructure for the public is concerned?
Like I said, there's an industrial park, and a 100 crore four lane has been sanctioned for that, so that it. Infrastructure is in place, and then you will see this will be the next investment destination as well as a tourism hub.
And what do you think the role UP will play in terms of India's achieving India's economic potential?
UP is going to be the growth engine for the next for some time to come now, which will be taking the economy of the country to the next level as the Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
While the BJP's fresh face for Pilibhit has chalked out his vision for the constituency, which definitely needs a lot of work, the ultimate power lies with the voter. So what are the issues that the people of Pilibhit will be voting on come the 19th of April? Let's hear them out. We are at the famous Chhatri Chauraha of Pilibhit, and we are here to talk to some of the people. As you can see, that this is an area that is bustling with economic activity. So we're going to speak to some shopkeepers and other people around here to understand what is it that they will be voting for. Bhai Saab, 19 अप्रैल को आप किस मुद्दे के लिए वोट करेंगे, आप क्या चाहते हैं पीलीभीत में, क्या सुधार आए?
पीलीभीत में बेरोजगार की संख्या ज़्यादा है और उनको नई फैक्ट्रियाँ लगाई जाएँ और विकास किया जाए, जिससे कि बेरोजगार जो है लोग जो है अपने कर सकें, परिश्रम करके अपना कुछ मिल सके उन्हें।
पीलीभीत में क्या अच्छा हो गया, क्या बेहतर हो सकता है?
जो भी बेहतर हो सकता है वो लोग खुद समझते हैं, राजनीति वाले हम लोग इस बात में क्या बताएंगे। विकास के लिए वो लोग अग्रसर हैं। यहाँ की जर्जर रोडें हैं, नाम को तो गड्ढे युक्त हो गई हैं लेकिन कभी गड्ढे पड़े हुए हैं, लोग मर रहे हैं उसमें।
देखिए, जब से भाजपा सरकार आई है तब से बहुत ही परिवर्तन देखने को मिला है, और अब चूँकि हमारे प्रत्याशी जो थे वो पहले ज़्यादा दिल्ली में रहते थे, पीलीभीत में कम रहते थे, इसलिए प्रत्याशी हमारा बदल दिया गया है। अब जितिन प्रसाद जी प्रत्याशी हैं, वो आपको शायद जानकारी हो या ना हो, उनकी पूरनपुर में ही जमीन पड़ी हुई है, वो पूरनपुर के आसपास ही रहने वाले हैं, तो अब स्थानीय प्रत्याशी होने के कारण मुझे लगता है बहुत अधिक बदलाव होगा।
इस समय पहले से बहुत अच्छा है, रोड बहुत अच्छे हो गए हैं, सफाई पर बहुत ध्यान दिया गया है और बीमारियों पर बहुत काबू पाया गया है। पहले बहुत दिक्कत थी, बीमारियाँ बहुत होती थी, साफ़ सफाई कम रहती थी, अब साफ सफाई बहुत अच्छी हो रही है।
पीलीभीत में एक तो यहाँ की सड़कें वड़कें ज़्यादा अच्छी नहीं हैं, रोडों में बहुत गड्ढे, अगर आप साइडों के रोडों में जाएंगे, मेन रोड को छोड़कर मेन रोड पे भी हैं। और दूसरी चीज़, यहाँ ये गाड़ियों की व्यवस्था, ट्रेन वेरन की व्यवस्था अभी तक कम से कम 18 से बंद हुई है, ये मैलानी लखनऊ वाला टुकड़ा अब तक चालू है, व्यापार चौपट है यहाँ पर।
युवा बेरोजगारों की समस्याओं को सॉल्व करना चाहिए, पढ़े लिखे लड़के खाली घूम रहे हैं, उनको रोजगार के अवसर प्रदान करना चाहिए।
अब यहाँ तो रोडों का विकास हुआ है, रोडें तो सही हुई है और बाकी तो हाँ पुल भी यहाँ स्वीकृत हुए हैं, कई एक पुल हुए, 20-22 पुल करीब यहाँ पीलीभीत में बने हैं। तो अब यह कल कारखानों की आवश्यकता है जो लोगों को रोज़गार मिले, बाकी यहाँ बहुत अच्छा हो गया रोडों का सबका।
रोड्स वगैरह मैडम यहाँ के बहुत ख़राब हैं, अंदर आप जाइए रोड हैं ही नहीं, बहुत ख़राब हैं, छोटी छोटी हैं और लोग जगह जगह ये अपने खोंचे उंचे लगा करके रोडों को और घेर लेते हैं, थोड़ा सा इसमें सुधार होना चाहिए। व्यवसाय नहीं है
यहाँ पर, सभी कुछ अच्छा ही हो रहा है और अच्छा हो भी चुका है यहाँ पर। ये देखिए, आप यहाँ से वहाँ देखेंगे, ये हाईवे बन रहे हैं, ओवर ब्रिज बन रहे हैं यहाँ पर, और बन चुके हैं जो ओवर ब्रिज, और खमीर का प्लांट वगैरह भी आ गया है यहाँ पे, मेडिकल कॉलेज भी बन रहा है यहाँ पर, और बाहर ये देखिए RDO ऑफिस बहुत भारी बन रहा है ये, और ये तहसीलें नई बन गई हैं सब यहाँ पर, और आप रोड तो देख ही रहे होंगे, अभी थोड़ा काम चल रहा है यहाँ पर, तो ये थोड़ा वैसा है लेकिन हाँ रोड भी बन रहा है पीलीभीत के। और आप आइए यहाँ पर, आप देखिए घूम के, ये टाइगर रिजर्व है, कितना सुंदर हो गया यहाँ पर, बहुत ज़्यादा विकास हुआ है यहाँ पर,
अच्छा हो रहा है, इससे आगे भी अच्छा होगा। हमारे मोदी जी ने बहुत अच्छा करा और हमारी सीट लिख लो भी है।
We took a moment to visit one of the few flute makers in Pilibhit today. This is Mohammad Usman, a fourth generation flute maker in Pilibhit city. आप क्या चाहते हैं गवर्नमेंट क्या करे, कैसे और बेहतर हो सकता है आपका, आपकी दुकान या आपका कारोबार कैसे बेहतर कर सकते हैं?
मतलब इसमें जैसे कि कुछ लोग हम ऐसा है कम पूंजी के हैं, उसमें लोन के लिए आसानी पैदा कर दिया है, जैसे 10%, 5% ये लाओ वो लाओ बैंक वाले कहते हैं, उसलिए गवर्नमेंट को हमारे लिए ये करना चाहिए। आसाम से जो माल चलता है ट्रेन से आना चाहिए, ट्रक से आता है, उसका 70-75 हज़ार रुपये भाड़ा जाता है यहाँ पे हम लोगों। ट्रेन बड़ी लाइन हो गई अब तो यहाँ पे भी, पहले छोटी लाइन थी जब आता था, अब आने में कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, जब बरेली पहले आता था अब जो यहाँ आ सकता है डायरेक्ट, ये है गवर्नमेंट से कहना हमारा, और आगे इसको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बढ़ावा दें इसको, ताकि हम लोगों को सुधार आए, हम लोगों बच्चे पढ़ लिखे, अच्छी शिक्षाएं पाएं, और भी इससे ये गवर्नमेंट सब चाहते हैं।
As the legacy keepers of a dying Indian craft, let's listen in to this family's appeals to the government.
पहले जो बांस आता था, पूरा बांस आता था, करीब 5-7 फुट का, तो उसमें हम लोग खुद कटिंग करते थे, उसमें हम अपनी मर्जी का माल निकाल लेते थे। अब जो जैसा आता है वैसे बनाना पड़ता है, जैसे हम लोग हम आप दुकान से आटा लाए, पकाया, थैली फेंक दी, वो हिसाब हो गया इसका।
The road to Pilibhit has witnessed a major transformation in step one of the Vikas plan. Greater connectivity through better roads has hopefully paved the way for development. With a flourishing tiger population, Pilibhit has recently made headlines for its growing incidence of man-animal conflict. This poses as a formidable challenge for its next political leader. From basic infrastructure and cleanliness to greater employment and a booming tiger tourism industry, all Pilibhit requires is vision and political will. That's all on this episode of The Roadstop on NewsX. Keep watching for our continuous coverage of the 2024 general elections. This is Devika Chopra with cameraman Avinash Shukla reporting from Pilibhit, Uttar Pradesh.